scheduling mechanism. We have unit test library and there that is currently being replaced by a new UC assert case way complete with the build system. And as Dave mentioned, we have some performance tools, Wednesday-based, and the ones that were shared with the community. Very nice Java-based performance tools. Our application there, and this is where we strayed off from what Michael Aguilar was saying, we actually release every application as an individual instead of grouping them all together in one package. There's actually a separate open source release for each application. All of them are ASCII certified applications, excluding our software bus work, which, as you mentioned, it's been a very popular application, so we wanted to get out there as quickly as possible, and so we released it as a prototype application. Then we've done work with the Software Plus Network, and we have made modifications. They're not available at open source yet, but they are available through a software use agreement. Our OSAL, it is including the API and all the OS implementations are all packaged together as one. And as Michael was saying, it is beneficial to release things as a package. We're finding as a community, it does prove some limitations. The community have been talking about when new implementation comes out. For example, Alan here, he's working on a free RTOP implementation. We want to just release the implementation at only time, and then release the API as the API changes with deployed. We won't have many API changes. Also true for the platform support packages, we found once an implementation is created, it's very rare. You know, there might be some bugs that include changes, but it's rare that we would really have to put out the whole platform support library, the whole, and really what we're adding are the new implementations to the new platform that the CSS is.
I mean, so then there's another challenge. I mean, just expanding what it means to release.
Right.
And who tests what on what platform? And it's become a very huge on whatever. Just something that, again, as we think as a community, you know, verifying on all the different platforms.
Everything that I mentioned on the previous slide is available open source, and it's open sourcing these different units is really what enabled the NASA-wide community. We wouldn't be able to work together and enhance the open source product or enhance the discussion units unless they were open source. So that was the start of it all. Community CTD, we've been in operation for approximately a year now. There have been several bug fixes and enhancements. We have a unit test, a search library, and that library as a single package is available open source. What the community decided to do was take the sub and functions that are associated with the OSAL and package them with the OSAL, and similarly, the CFE hook and sub functions will be packaged with the CFE. This will replace the unit test library that's currently delivered with the CFE called the UTF unit test framework. There's a CMake build environment, and we're really looking into adding electronic data sheets. There were a bunch of prerequisite to get the electronic data sheets compatible with the CFS, and we're currently working on those enhancements. We have some upcoming releases. A goal to release this out by the end of the calendar year. CFB 6.5, GoCell 4.2, CFB 1.3, and we will be releasing the OCL and the CFB again as one full unit. We have some application releases. Once CFB 6.5 goes out with these electronic data sheets, there's two applications that access some data structures. Won't be compatible with the new CFB, so we'll be putting out some quick fix releases to solve the compatibility issues there. So then is where we now this is just a listing for reference of all of the open source applications, CFB, OCL, CFB, and what their current version number is when you get out on SourceForge. These are the versions that you're going to find. So where can we find CFS? It is always maintenance. CFE, which is a complete out-of-the-box solution, is available on SourceForge. The OSAL is available on SourceForge. The PSDs, again, are packaged in with the CFE. We have the public csfc.nasa.gov website. If you go to that page on the left-hand side, you can find all the SourceForge links for the TSS and the OSAL. And so the application suite is available on SourceForge. It's available as a single suite, but in each application is in separate SourceForge projects. And now that we have open sourced these components, we have provided the CSS on a shared NASA repository called Stablefish. It is a GIF system. It also includes track for issue tracking. What the community did was we took the components and broke them up into six separate repositories. So the CFB, like I said, it was packaged on SourceForge as a complete out-of-the-box solution that included the PFB and the tools. What the community did to help manage these components is broke them up. So we have the CFB, which is just the APIs and the CFB applications. And then we also have a separate PFB repository and a separate tools repository where you'll find the build systems, table tools, the building tables, the current unit test framework, which going away, so again, we'll be integrating those frameworks into the CFB and the ASL. We have a repository, and then Greg's wonderful idea was to create this test repository, and we'll get more into what that test repository is used for in some upcoming slides. So, Stablefish, anyone with master credentials is able to access Stablefish, which will allow them access to each one of these repositories. And
do not attach me for NBC account credentials. I'm not the person to you to talk to get NBC credentials. Who do you talk to? After you have any credentials you want to check. That getting any credentials way over my grade.
Excellent point. So once NDC credentials are acquired and you would like access to Stablefish, that's when Greg will be a wonderful help to you.
Know who to talk to get NDC credentials.
So this I just did a just, I guess we can get through this pretty quickly. These just really show what, if you download the CFE firewall off of Foolish Boards, this shows the directory structure and everything that you're going to get. So again, the community took out this little CFE box that includes the source code and the test results and documentation such as the DD and user guide stuff. And again, that Babelfish is in a separate repository. It also took out the TSP that's in its own separate repository on Babelfish. And then in the CFE, we stripped out the tools and that is in separate repository on Babelfish. But in the open source firewall, you get all this good stuff. And also, we see OSAL, well, it is a part of the CFS, but it's also its own standalone project. And so it comes complete its own build system. It has some tests and examples on how to use the OSAL. And then, again, each center is managing their own OS implementation. The applications, I just took one as an example. But what you get in the tarball is all the documentation. It includes user guide, version description documents, requirements are included in that, all the flight software, and then the nuts and grounds, the build testing that is done at the Goddard facility, all the test results and reports are included in the testing ground folder. So again, the community, how we came about, starting with the timeline. Again, all this started when the OSAL and the CFE went open source, and I can't remember exactly when the OSAL went open source, but I took a peek on source boards and looked at the very first OSAL tarball that was made available, and it was right at the end of 2010, and CFE was to follow, and that really, making that open source is really what spread the word that this reusable practice is out there. So shortly after the OSAL and CFE went open source, Baltimore started using CFS. At this time, it was really the CFE. In the past, we've seen a lot of CFE / CFS. Now we've kind of grouped it all together and think of it just as the core flight system. In about 2011, a lot of centers started using CFS. Goddard started getting some wonderful feedback from the centers and these success stories about how the CFS stayed. You know, we had this crazy client schedules to meet, and with the help of the CFS, they were able to meet their deadlines and schedules and get their mission completed on time. And so these success stories and the experience of that, hey, there is a product line out there that really demonstrates the power of reuse. So, and we're also not only using it, but creating tools and projects, you're also finding bugs and developing fixes for those bugs. And so right around the end of 2012, there really was this nationwide interest in establishing a community so we could prevent, again, the reinventing of the wheel. We could share these bug findings and fixes. We could share the tools that were making it easier and easier to use CFS as a whole. So in mid-around June 2014, it was actually Glenn Research Center said, hey guys, can we start to have these workshops where the center get together and start sharing all the good work that we've done that started around the CFS, and we also speak with the Brainia. So we started having these workshops and sharing all the good work that we have done. And finally, we, in December 2014, we had a week-long workshop, and that's really where the community was officially established. We came out of that workshop with a written plan of action was to formulate the change control board. Again, the change control board now has been in operation for just about a year. We meet our teleconference 5 weeks also, I threw in here, at the time that we had this workshop, we had the OSL and CFE open source, but that application it was still in the open source paperwork process, which made lengthy process, and centers that had been using applications through software user agreements were anxiously awaiting for the application to go open source. Because as new products came, these software user agreements bind the use of that software to a project. And so in order for them to use the application suite on a future project, until that suite is open source, they would have to go through the whole paperwork process to fill out another software user agreement. So there was a lot of anxiety around getting the application suite open source. And fortunately, shortly after the community was established, the application suite went out open source. This enabled us as a community to provide our Babelfish and all our repositories set up. So for now, again, I don't have in here. We did. As a community, we put out a hot fix, CFE 642. We found some startup race conditions that were critical to get out to the open source community. So in mid-2015, we threw out a hot fix of the CFE and out a new tarball with that hot fix included in there. And what we're doing as a community is we're finalizing our OSAL CFC and CFC release. This I thought was a great quote, and this was a quote that came from our December 2014 workshop that really summarizes how we all came together and really is a great mission statement here. We didn't have a way to discuss our lessons learned, share and discuss the changes being made and the resources being developed. And so the whole community was to enable this great collaboration. So getting into the change control board. And the purpose was now that the CFS is open source was to manage the open source releases from a community standpoint and leveraging the enhancements and the bug fixes that are being made at the different participating centers, which includes APL. So bi-weekly, and we also have special topic meetings scheduled as needed. The CCP chair was actually myself, and that was elected by the participating centers. I also have primary and alternate leads from each center you know, to just, you know, have this closed group of primary and alternate leads. So we've really opened the CCB up. Anyone with NASA credentials can join into the meetings, have access to the meeting and participate. You know, we welcome everyone's comments and feedback, and whether or not they approve or disapprove of the changes that we're talking about. So if anyone is interested in joining the CCB, I'm the primary point of contact, and I'd be happy to set up on our CCB email list and get you going there. So which of this is our product listing and everything that is available open source is now being managed by the CCB through the repositories on Datafish. And go through our processes of how we get to CREMA, an official release that we then go out on source storage.
Where we can say, yes, we're going to fit that into our development branch.
what drives us is our mission and project support. We're all here because of our mission and project support. What drives our releases, a big part of that is the mission and project needs. Our upcoming releases are heavily driven by Orion and their backup flight computer is going to be using CSS, and they will be utilizing the upcoming releases. These two hand in hand, the mission project support is what drives available staffing. Who is available to contribute to the CCD and support the CCD? And then these two go hand in hand. Schedule, the mission project needs are what's driving the CCD schedule. So our change management process, government has access to data push, enter a ticket. The ticket and they follow the ticket flow and have a very great chart that shows our ticket flow. We'll get into ticket flow, but when a ticket gets entered, it doesn't look like it's there. User away, they can start working on the ticket and incorporating changes and further change out in the branch on the Git repository. Then they'll send out a notification to the CD chair, hey, I have some changes that are ready for review. The CCD chair will assign these tickets or change sets for the CCD members to review.
Yeah, my question was, do you need the NASA credentials to access Babelfish, or can you do this without it?
The question was, does someone need NBC or NASA credentials? Access Babelfish, which would allow them to enter a ticket, and the answer is yes, you do need NASA credentials, but
we're working on that.
We're working on that. That's one of the things that Dave mentioned, which is we'd like to have a public shared website. We would like to share our slides. So in Dave McComas's slides, he had talked about Shrek, who's working with us to put together this public way where we could be able to have a shared Git system where we can enter the ticket. But right now, we're confined to the NASA community, and this is the process that we're following. So, again, once changes are ready for review, the CCD chair will assign it to the CCD members to review. And if the changes are simple enhancements or bug fixes, usually reviewed at the next upcoming CCD meeting. However, we found that more detailed changes will require one more special topic meeting where we may have to get into the design and then start in deeper in the details of the design and things like that. And this step three, I think is Dave mentioned this concept of virtual team, and in a way we've already had this going on with the different centers creating apps and implementations and so virtually they've been doing additions, and I think a lot of these special topic meetings will be centered around the work done and performed by these virtual teams. So once the CCD chair assigns the change sets and tickets for review, the CCD members will go off in their own time and review the changes. and we'll use the Bagelfish chat system to communicate with each other, and we can submit comments and start discussions. Larger changes, and then when our telecom CCB meetings occur, that's when we get better as a group, and we just position those changes. So if they're either approved or disapproved, or sometimes deferred, whether it's just too large a change that to make a decision at that time. Yes, and again, I'd like to get these slides out, and as you go through them, you have my point of contact and any of the details you didn't have time to discuss. So I'm going to jump way ahead. That was our release process. This is our tick flow. Have a stretching model. That my draft, it helps the Vincent Stratton's model, which is shown on this slide. What the model doesn't show is our addition of the technology branch that allows us to share new technologies without incorporating them into the official release. Because again, we're maintaining Class B processes and software that will get merged back into our masters. Summary, you can see we've done some work here. All of what you see here, 41 OSA, 14 PSC, and 44 CSC are all merged into our development branch or into release. These were our closed tickets that are currently in the development branch. And if you want to go, please, but just here is reference. And Babelfish.
1 minute to go ahead. The 1 minute summary. We have a server called Babelfish. It's made by NASA Ames. They allowed us to use it. We have a series of Git repository projects, and we have a Bamboo server. So we have new plans that are running automated building tests of many branches of both PME and OSA. The scripts that Bamboo runs are all in the test repository under a Bamboo branch. But you want to set up automated tests for their mission, their project, those scripts are available. I've tried to keep the Bamboo plans installed very simple because Bamboo is a web that I can control. So everything it does is all in shell scripts. So as long as you're in Bamboo, those shell scripts should work. If you're running other CM servers, it will probably work. That's 1 minute.
To be clear, that's all at unit level testing, correct?
Based on the Bamboo test I did on Laddie after the Laddie mission, this can run unit testing, but it can also be dovetailed with longer functional tests and very long scenario tests. We're running unit level testing and functional level testing as part of our build turnaround times under 5 minutes. We have the capability to build plans that will stage a scenario plan training. The scenario runs overnight. The next day, you poke a button and read the results. Go right back into the Bamboo test.
With a closed loop software system?
Absolutely. We can logical based development, which means model testing, which means closed loop, run your software with real hardware simulation, and get back with the results of the joint. Have another hour to talk about testing. I can go on forever about it. That's 1 minute.
So, you're putting it here, obviously.
I hope everybody is doing automated building tests.
Yeah,
please.
I think that's a great place to go.
Any questions?
I had a question. So there's also iPads, and generally, Babelfish or
iPads, as far as I'm concerned, I have the pure Babelfish. Repository is concerned. The only difference is that the CC is paying attention to trouble tickets that are on Babelfish. So generally people go to Babelfish to put in trouble tickets because the ticketing system is not distributed. Yes, it's distributed. So we make sure the developer and the master branches and the upcoming technology branches will be in sync between GigaFish and iPad. So a project standpoint, it doesn't matter which one you fetch from. In fact, I would say set up remotes for both of them in case one goes away. Welcome to there's a diversion control system. Nobody's the master. By the way, which center hosts iPads? JSC. Woohoo. Thank you.
I think we have to do some internal work because I don't really want duplication. I mean, if we can go to Bagelfish to get the source, we should be using that. I think there's some potential for what they were doing at PEP for application level sharing, and I think they were trying to spearhead an effort for that. So I think maybe if we, I think we have to talk to internally, but this year we've already identified that as something we want to honor. And one of the things I think I want to go towards get rid of the iPads for getting the layers and use this as the, you know, the authority. And maybe some app level stuff and some project level sharing could be done on the iPad.
Whatever you guys want to sign up for, I'm okay with. I just remember that in the original meeting, it was to build this thing called iPad that 6 months out, and I said, hey, we need to do something available for you. Meanwhile, I didn't know whether you want us to take lead on this or not. As long as we have funding and as long as the people that run Bagelfish are happy to allow us to use their resources. We are just on Bagelfish, we don't own it. It's a NASA thing. Anybody else?
One thing for general was talking about the slides. Traditionally, the other play software workshops are put up on the APL site. Is there any reason why these slides can't be put up?
There's no reason why they can't be put up.
Okay.
Yeah.
We have to go through the. Yeah, we do. Yeah, we have to go through a release
right.
process.
2 to 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Right.
Sorry.
Yeah.
But if you're civil servant, everybody, I know that within the NASA group, it's not an issue. But for those outside, I think that would be the easiest place.
Yeah.
Normal, we were all preparing things at the last, you know. So, and we haven't gone through our process.
We're doing it.
Yeah. Getting more formal.
This has been in the detailed slides that you got skipped. The CCB, I was starting to pick it and then really quickly to assume there was a change set that was were actually being reviewed. So, we're in here just, okay, was it just missing an off?
No, that's broken to some extent right now. It's going to change in that the ticket gets reviewed and then finally. And bug fixes. Kind of ticket.
They either fixed it or worked so freely it didn't go bad.
Yeah,
that night.
That.
Okay.
Yes, we need it. Yeah, there's a different.
The basic idea on that was up until now, we've been official. We are accepting a large number of changes from various projects already had changes before. I came into this with a great change from Laddie. Joe Mock came in with a bunch of changes he made, and so on down the line. We all had a bunch of things we wanted to contribute, so we had five different years of change. That was our model. So as we mature into, okay, we've dealt with this huge backlog of everybody with their complaint overlapping changes. We'll eventually in this case, we're actually doing, here's something we need to do. Let's review it, decide to do it, have somebody spend the effort. So to that, we may not change the actual state flow of the ticket. We may come from new and go into it. Right, stay there until I change that. One thing I want to mention about this is we've got a lot of stage, a lot of little teeny arrows. As an engineer, I really hate it. When I have to sit there, we should track tracking system. We step my ticket through 47 steps to get it from where it is to where it needs to be. So every one of them, there's shortcuts. I can take a ticket, it comes in new. So file a new ticket, and you file a change set. And right from the CCD, and the CCD brings it up, and we all say, hey, that's more than that pile, let's do it. I write down the test complete. If that thing is after a bamboo testing, we can write it, test complete, have CCD final review real close. One or two steps.
Right, so this flow was started to support the community when we started, where there was a lot of work that getting that work integrated.
The other thing we wanted to do was changing this flow involves extra work in trying to get the initialization files constructed and put it in and get somebody who owns Babel Fish to deal with the traffic. But we didn't want to have something where we're going to change it every month. We were hoping that this design would last us for a while. So far, so well. I think as we go to a more mature scheme, we may not need to change this as much. So we may be able to get away with not actually changing the way the tickets flow and just kind of in our heads say, okay, well, here's what we're going to do with tickets. We'll hold in review, we'll move it over to assigned on hold and work, and so on. And we'll start more use of all the stages that we set up initially. How that shakes out, we get more tickets of the new sort.
Right. And if we made it to my last five.
We have
this ticket flow. This is actually one of the first things that the CCD have worked together as a team. On Babel Fish, we have a wiki page that describes the ticket flow in detail. What we don't have, again, this is all grassroots, so we really much formalize this as a process. Bring in our software quality code and stamp it with approval. And again, kickstart the community, because that's what's going to really get us to the stars. We this came from a special topic. We had a road map plan forward meeting with the community and put out our release schedule. So really what's driving this is our upcoming project, the Ryan being the big one. We also have daughter, and so everything, all those slides, all the tickets. That's what's currently sitting in our development branch for the OSAL and the CSP and CHS and storage management. And then we've also, Justin, Lawyer Cost Group has gone through a state certification effort. They've run the code through MIDRA. We did code reviews on the findings. Updates were made. Unit tests were added to get full coverage. And all that good work is going to be folded in, and that's what's coming out on upcoming releases, which we hope to get the OSAL and PSC by Thanksgiving. And we're going to start it on a platter of turkey. And then Santa Claus is going to come in with the reindeer and deliver the sea, and that's the plan. I great out after the new year. It's a little bit fuzzy what we're going to be doing, because we're at a point there we're dealing a whole lot with bug fixes and minor enhancements, but more looking at the new technology and how we can incorporate those changes into our open source releases, and again, really establish this concept of the virtual team so we can keep the ball moving forward and get to a point where the CCD is ready for you and adding things into the development branch and or technology branches.
All right. Well, thank you. Maybe a 10-minute break would be useful, even though it's not a schedule, but we'll clear our heads a little bit. And then 11:20.
I'm so glad my voice held out.
I think you were getting stronger.
on Saturday.